Why, hello there. My name is Martin McKenzie. I'm one of the four pathologists working for Forest Health Protection in the state and private wing of the Forest Service. I'm here to tell you about Sporax and Cellu-Treat application, the pesticides we use to control Heterobasidion root rot disease here in California. I know that Sporax is no longer available to be bought, but if you have a supply of Sporax, you can use it. But before we start, I'm going to go over the PPE that you must wear when applying these pesticides. As you can see, I'm wearing gloves, so I have a trick question for you. Can I wear leather gloves while applying a pesticide? You know the answer. The answer is no, because leather gloves can absorb the pesticide and it can be absorbed into your skin. However, I'm cheating. I'm wearing approved gloves underneath my leather gloves. The other thing that you must wear for PPE are boots, long-sleeved shirts, pants, and you must wear eye goggles. So here I am, fully prepared to go into the woods and treat stumps. And here I have a simulated stump that we are going to treat with Cellu-Treat. I have mixed up a small quantity of the chemical with food coloring dye so that it can be seen. On any of your applicating equipment, you must have the signal word, the name of the chemical, and the EPA number, and your name and address. And you should also have in your truck access to the materials safety data sheet and the label so that you know what it is you're dealing with. The label is used to tell you how to apply the chemical properly, but the materials data safety sheet is needed because if you have an accident or a spill, the first thing you should do is grab the materials safety sheet, phone the 1-800 number, and those people are going to ask you, what is the EPA number of the chemical? They've already got all the information they need to give you sound advice on what you should do with your problem, be it a spill or somebody accidentally exposed to the chemical. So now we are ready to give you a demonstration of a simulated Cellu-Treat application. And I'm doing no more than wetting the surface of the stump. We are not trying to soak to run off because we don't want to contaminate the environment with this pesticide because it is also an insecticide. It's a simple operation. You spray the stump, you move on to the next one. Now, as almost every forester knows, the active ingredient in Sporax is exactly the same active ingredient that's in borax, washing soap. But can we use this on stumps? The answer is no, because to use it on stumps, we would be violating the law. The second thing I want to bring up is, do you recognize this? It's a Gatorade bottle. It's a perfect shape and size. You punch some holes in the top and it makes a perfect shaker. But you cannot do this. It is illegal. You have put a pesticide in a human use container. You have to put the pesticide in a non-human use container. And the other thing you have to do, just as I had to do with my spray tank, put the signal word, danger. Put the word Sporax on it. Give your name and address, and I'll be honest, I should also have had the EPA number on this. I have given you a brief introduction to the application of borates to control Heterobasidion to ensure that we are within the rules, within the law, and above all else are safe.